A string splice is an emergency repair. We may not have to make it often, but when it is needed, we have to be able to do it right on the first attempt. We need a way to remember the structure of the splice, and we need a script to help us remember the process of making the splice in the piano. This exercise teaches the structure, the schematic of the splice. The two loops of the splice are mirror images. Your hands are also mirror images. Think of your index finger as the length of string pointing to the bridge pin or the tuning pin. Point your index finger and fold your thumb underneath it, representing the loop you will make on the string. You will need to make one right-hand loop and one left-hand loop. When the two loops are pointed in opposite directions, they fit together to make a strong, permanent splice. Now you do it. Make your right-hand memory model and see how the big splice model matches it. Then make your left-hand memory model and see how the big splice matches it. Then fit the two pieces together. Notice the structure. See how the two tails are pointing in opposite directions, and they are locked together in the center of the splice. Reach into the splice box and select one loop. Identify it. Is it right-handed or left-handed? Now pick another loop and see if it's the opposite of your first. Keep searching till you have one right-hand loop, one left-hand loop. Assemble it and make sure you've made the right choices. Take them apart and toss the pieces back in the box for the next student. Now you'll make your own sample splice. Take a piece of the pre-cut wire and clamp it in the vice grips. Point your finger and point the wire. Turn your thumb under your finger. Now, turn the wire underneath. Do the same thing with your other hand as the model. Bend the wires down over the tails a bit to help the loops fit together. Assemble the wires to create your splice. Make a few more until you are happy with the result. Show it to a teacher to get credit for this exercise, and take it home for a memento of this moment when you learned the schematic of a string splice.